Dear students and my teacher friends, Namaskar. I welcome you to the presentation lecture on the fork line method for determining gamete genotype frequency. So in this lecture we are using fork line method, and by the fork line method we are determining the genotypes as well as the phenotype and phenotypic frequency. We are finding out by the fork line method for the gametes. Okay, so let's start the lecture. See, before we jump on to this topic, fork line method for determining the gamete genotype frequency, before we discuss that, let's brush up our concept for the dihybrid cross. Okay, see, Mendel wanted to know how two character or the two trait or the two phenotype inherited simultaneously in the progeny. Okay, and the two character that he started with is the seed surface and the seed color. So both the plant he took was true breeding. Okay, so the meaning of true breeding now we are knowing. So this is the parent, okay, parent generation, and as you can see, this plant is producing the round seed. Round seed means the seeds are having the smooth surface and the color of the seed is yellow. Now here you see to show the allele, he used the capital letter RR for the surface, that is the round one, and instead of Y you will find in different book they are using the different letters. Okay, so in the previous lecture we have seen that in that book they have used the they had used capital Y for yellow color, but over here they are using capital G for the yellow color. Okay, so small g in this plant, small g is for the green color and small r is for the wrinkle surface. Okay, now the gamete formation. So this one is the male parent, this one is the female parent. Okay, so here the allele small r small g in the male gamete, and in the female gamete the alleles are capital R, capital G. Now this male gamete fertilizes the female gamete, so there is a zygote formation, and once the zygote is formed, all the ovules are transformed into seed. Okay, so in the pod all the seed are heterozygous. So Mendel planted all this seed, okay, and this seed are heterozygous. Okay, that means they are all round and they were all yellow color. Now this are the, by planting this seed Mendel got the F1 plant, and in the F1 plant Mendel allowed the selfing. So by allowing the selfing in the F1 plant, the pods were produced, and inside the pod the seeds are present. Okay, so these seeds are the part of the F2 generation. Okay, so F1 plant are having, after fertilization the pods are formed, and in the pod the seeds are present, and these seeds are the part of the F2 generation. Okay, so now here when the selfing is performed, okay, which is the natural tendency in pea plant for reproduction. So during selfing, so pollen are going to produce, okay, and there are ovule. So this pollens are going to produce the gametes, and the ovules are producing the eggs. Okay, so now what are the, now the question is, 1 minute, Okay, so here you can see pollen produces the gamete, and in the ovule egg is there. Okay, so now the question is, what are the genotype and the phenotype of this male gamete and the egg, female gamete? Okay, what is the phenotype, what is the genotype, and what is the frequency? So this factor we are determining by the fork line method. We are using the fork line method for this. Okay, okay, now here you see figure 2.10. okay, figure 2.10, what this figure is showing, diagrammatic aid called the fork line method diagram. This figure is showing, and this figure is used to determine gamete genotype and the frequency. Okay, so let's discuss this method. Okay, see, now again, see, second point is written over here, but before that, this is the F1. okay, let's say from this seed F1 generation plant is grown up. Okay, and when the flower of this F1 generation plant, when they start selfing, so they are going to produce male and female gamete. Okay, let's say to understand this concept, let's say the 100 male gametes are produced. Okay, so in F1 plant, let's say for example 100 male gametes are produced. Okay, so now let's read this point. See, the fork line diagram illustrates that one half of all gametes produced by an heterozygous capital R, small r, capital G, small g plant will contain capital R, and half will contain small r. Okay, so as I told you, this F1 plant, we are allowing selfing, and if the flowers are producing 100 male gamete, okay, so that means half means 50 male gamete, that is 50 means 1/2. Okay, that means the half the gamete, they contain capital R allele, and half the gamete, that means 50, they are containing the small r allele. Okay, so again, to understand this concept, okay, let's say the F1 generation plant flower, they are producing 100 male gamete. So amongst this 100, 50 gamete, that is the 1/2, are having capital R allele, and 50 gametes are having 1/2 r. okay, any small r. So 50 male gamete, they are having capital R allele, and 50 male gamete, they are having small r allele. Okay, this is the second point. Okay, now two more point we are discussing in this figure. Okay, I am hiding this figure right now. Okay, see, on my back you can see genotype and frequency. Okay, but I know you want to see the figure, but to watch this complete lecture, you have to log into my app. Okay, see, right now I am recording this lecture, and after recording I am uploading this lecture on my app. Okay, so to watch this full lecture, I invite you on my app. You purchase the membership of my app, and you can watch this full lecture. And the information, okay, information to deliver this lecture, So if you are interested in knowing the name of the book, so I will send you a PDF. Then in the PDF you will get the information regarding the books, okay, that I have used for this lecture, okay. All the information, book name, the author, publication company, edition, everything you will get, okay. I will send you the message. My name is Manish Koshti sir. I am from Ahmedabad, India. Bye bye.